this story to read to you today. It's all about going to the seaside, and it's about our friend Winnie. It's called Winnie at the Seaside by Valerie Thomas and Corky Paul. Can you see Wilbur hiding? He's hiding behind the sandcastle. It was a very hot summer. Winnie the Witch felt hot and tired. Wilbur, her cat, felt hot and tired too. "I want to swim, Wilbur," Winnie said. "Let's go to the seaside." Winnie found her beach towel, her beach bag, and her beach umbrella. I think she's forgetting something. What do you think you would take to the beach? That's clever. Do you know what? I think I would take a cup to collect lots of shells in. I love collecting shells. She jumped onto her broomstick. Wilbur jumped on her shoulder. And they were off. They flew over hot towns, hot roads, hot cars. And then they came to the sea. There were lots of people on the beach, but Winnie found a place for her towel. It's right at the front here. She put up her beach umbrella and got ready for her swim. "Look after my bag and my broomstick, Wilbur," Winnie said. She ran into the water. It was lovely in the sea. Winnie splashed through the water and skipped over the waves. She was having a lovely time. Wilbur sat and watched her. He couldn't swim. He didn't like water. And he hated getting wet. Winnie dived into the water. It was such fun. But the water started to creep up the sand, up to Winnie's towel. Wilbur jumped onto Winnie's beach umbrella. "Meow!" he cried. Then the sea picked Winnie up, turned her over three times, one, two, three, and dumped her onto the sand. The water washed over Winnie's towel and came halfway up Winnie's beach bag. "Meow!" cried Wilbur. He didn't want to get wet. "Oh dear," said Winnie. She shook some seaweed out of her hair. "Don't worry, Wilbur, we'll just move further up the beach." She picked up her beach bag and her towel. "My broomstick!" cried Winnie. "Where's my broomstick?" She looked everywhere. But no broomstick. Can you see Winnie's broomstick? Right over here. But Winnie's losing lots of things out of her bag as well. She's lost her hairbrush, her perfume, a fork, her sunscreen. Then she looked out to sea. And there was her broomstick floating away. "Stop!" Winnie shouted, but her broomstick didn't stop. "How will we get home, Wilbur?" said Winnie. Then she had an idea. She grabbed her beach bag, took out her magic wand, waved it five times. One, two, three, four, five, and shouted, "Abracadabra!" The broomstick stopped. Then it started to come back. But a surfer was in the way. It's knocked onto the surfer. And what What is down here? Shall we find out? Whoosh! Went the broomstick high up into the air, and it landed on a whale. The whale didn't want a broomstick on his back. Whoosh! Went the broomstick high into the air in a great spout of water. Whoosh! Splash! Winnie's broomstick had come back to Winnie was pleased. The other people on the beach were not pleased at all. They were all wet. Wilbur was not pleased either. He was very wet, very sandy, and rather squashed. Oh, look, Wilbur's under here. Oh dear, Winnie said. We'd better go home, Wilbur. She packed everything up, then Winnie and Wilbur zoomed up into the sky. They were soon home again. It was still hot in Winnie's garden. Winnie still felt hot and tired. Then she had a wonderful idea. She took out her magic wand out of her beach bag, shut her eyes, turned around three times, one, two, three, and shouted, Abracadabra! There, in her garden, was a beautiful swimming pool. Winnie dived in. She swam up and down and she floated on her back. This is lovely, Wilbur, she said. It's much nicer than the seaside. Anything is nicer than the seaside, thought Wilbur. The end. What I want to know is, do you like the seaside or the swimming pool better? I like the swimming pool because I don't really like sand. But do you like the seaside or the swimming pool better?